In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a reset button in your PDF fillable form in Adobe Acrobat Pro. So when a user clicks it, it'll reset and clear out all the data in the form fields. I'm also going to show you how to format the appearance of the reset button. Let's take a look. First, I'm going to open up my PDF fillable form in Adobe Acrobat Pro. I'm going to look at my form and decide where I want to place my reset form button. I think I'm going to place it up here in the top right. Over on All Tools, I'm going to click on View More, and scroll down and click on Prepare a Form. All of the different tools and components pop up here on the left-hand side that you'll need to create your fillable PDF form. I'm going to go ahead and drag this pane over so that we can see more of our form. In the list of components over here on the left, I'm going to click the icon that says Button. And notice when I bring my mouse over onto the document, I'll see an outline of this button. So I can move my mouse where I want to place the button and click. I'm going to hit Escape twice, and then I'm going to double click to open the properties of the button. Under the General tab, I can name this anything I want to name this form field. I'm going to call it Reset. Now under the Options tab, I can choose what I want this button to be. I'm going to leave it as just a label, but I want the label to read Reset Form. Now I can change the appearance of the button. Go over to the Appearance tab, and I have lots of different options under borders and colors. For example, I can put a gray border that can be thin. My fill color on the button can be white since it's on a blue background, and I can even change the font. Now let's program this to reset all the form fields on the form. To do that, I'm going to go up to the Actions tab. The select trigger we're going to leave as defaulted to mouse up. What that means is when a user clicks and releases the click of that button, it will trigger the action to occur. When we select an action, we have a drop-down list, and it may be defaulted to execute a menu item. Just scroll down till you get to Reset a Form, then click Add. Here we have a Reset Form menu item that pops up, and we can actually select which of the form fields in your document that you want to trigger for the action. So you may not want to reset all of the form fields. You can deselect any fields that you want to leave unselected. I'm going to go ahead and select all because I want to reset all of the form fields when a user clicks the button. Then I'm going to click OK. Once I'm done with the appearance and the label and the action on my Reset Form button, I'm going to click Close. Now let's go ahead and test our form. Over here on the left, under Prepare Form, you'll see a Preview button. Go ahead and click on Preview. Now let's fill in some information on our form. All right, now let's go ahead and click on Reset Form. Notice that all the form fields we filled in have been cleared out. I'm going to exit Preview, and I'm going to go ahead and save my document. Go to Menu, Save As, navigate where you want to save, name your file, and click on Save. Now you're ready to distribute your form with the Reset Form button. Be sure and share this video with your friends and give it a thumbs up to like it. Subscribe to my channel and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.